They are also very valuable in interpreting for Al-Shabaab trainers of American and Western dissidents. They could be used for anything they want. They could be trained or forced to become suicide members, bombers in Somalia, and they can do in out of desperation. For many of them, Burhan, for example, have no idea where he could go for help in Somalia. This is the first time he has been to Somalia in his life. These are basically the main reason why Al-Shabaab is recruiting from the Western countries. Another issue of paramount importance is the fact that we are the first family members who informed the law enforcement about the missing of these youth. Family members whose children sent to Somalia were scared to even talk to the law enforcement. We have been painted as a bad people within the Somali community by the mosque management. We have been treated for just speaking out. Some members of Abu Bakr al-Sadiq Mosque told us that if we talk about the issue, the Muslim center will be destroyed and Islamic communities will be wiped out. They tell parents that if they report their missing kid to FBI, that FBI will send the parents to Guantanamo jail. And this message has been a very effective tool to silence parents and the community. They do have a lot of cash to use for propaganda machine. They strike fear on a daily basis here in Minneapolis among Somali-speaking community in order to stop the community to cooperate with the law enforcement agencies. Public threats were issued to us at Abu Bakr al-Sadiq Mosque for simply speaking with the CNN and Newsweek and other media. The other mystery is that they say something in Somali TVs at the congregation and say something contrary to that in English while speaking to the mainstream media or community. They also told us not to talk to the media because that will also endanger the Muslim leaders. We have been projected as barrier within the community by these mosque leaders. We are tormented by the fact that our children are missing and in peril. These members are scaring us so that we stop talking to the law enforcement. Perspective on Al-Shabaab to attract young people to their cause. The Somali importance factor on how Al-Shabaab attracts the young Somali Americans is the indoctrination of the children. They are programmed to understand that it's their duty to confront the infidels. They are youth programs that in some instances have some hidden agendas. These agendas include that whatever issues that might come across in life is twisted as being the work of the infidels. They have been told to understand that the Ethiopian troops in Somalia are casted as an act of aggression against the Islamic religion. Al-Shabaab is not only interested in recruiting Somali American youth, but others in the Western countries, such as UK, Germany, Canada, and Australia. The main reason for Al-Shabaab to recruit from these countries is that these youth have different view than a typical Somali in Somalia. They do not know much about Somali clan and have no political affiliation whatsoever. There are some radical groups who are a minority in their thinking. However, when the Ethiopian troops came to Somalia, some Somali American professors clearly declared the war against Ethiopian troops. This has been a scapegoat for their extremist political views. It encouraged radical Islamic groups in US who previously were not active in the political activities here in Somalia. In conclusion, we, the families of the missing kids, have been conducting an outreach campaign to reach out those families that has not come forward. We believe this is the tip of the iceberg in our outreach. We have been very successful to help some families to come forward and trust the law enforcement agencies like we did. Recommendation for preventing recruitment in the future. Educating members to the Somali community on the importance of the cooperation between law enforcement and the community. Empower the families of the missing kids to continue the outreach to those families who did not come forward. Bring to justice those who are responsible. Create a special task force to combat the Al-Shabaab recruitment in Minnesota, Ohio, Washington, Seattle, and Boston.